On September the 1st, Cage Warriors returns to Liverpool for a vacant lightweight championship fight. And boy, have we got a cracker on our hands. Two of the hottest prospects, the biggest followings in European MMA will go at it. Two young titans. Søren, two Viking back, returns to Liverpool. And the city's own, Paddy the Baddy Pimblett, will go at it once and for all to see who is the new lightweight champion of the world. Søren?
Yeah?
You're going to be the one stepping into the Lions then on September the 1st. This is a fight that you yourself called for.
Yeah.
What have you seen in this man that makes you believe that you can be victorious?
So there's multiple things to take account for. So Paddy got a massive following, so it's going to be a huge fight. And also, he's a guy with a lot of highlight reel finishes, so it's also going to be an exciting fight. But also, I see that my style is much more tight than his more rather loose jiu-jitsu style, and I think it's going to be match up well against me.
How does it make you feel, Pad, when a guy from a different country, he's been here, he's tasted your environment, he's fought in your arena, he wants to come here, he wants to beat you, and he wants to take the world championship? How is that?
It's nice, isn't it? At least people want to fight you, you know what I mean? It's nice to have people calling your name, and I done the same with him, know what I mean? I wanted to fight him. It's nice to have people who are good on the European scene that'll fight, know what I mean? Like, so the people shy away from tough fights, but we haven't, know what I mean? We've took the hardest fight out there, and I can't wait to put on a show for everyone in this very arena come September 1st.
Both you guys are frequently talked about with a UFC kind of future and all this kind of thing, and as Paddy points out then, it may have been easy for you to avoid one another, but instead, both of you are committed to putting it all on the line.
Yeah, we could have. We could have easily probably turned down the title fight and just said, no, we'll fight someone else. Søren could have fought someone in Europe and I could have just fought someone different here, know what I mean? But it's not what we're about. We want to test ourselves. What's the point in getting in the UFC to then not be good enough and get cut? You need to test yourself outside the UFC to have the good fights and then get in the UFC after that.
That's so true. Just got to take the toughest fight possible to make sure that you're at that level before you get to that level.
Both you guys on paper are outstanding ground fighters. Do you expect it to become a ground battle, Søren? Wrestling versus jiu-jitsu?
Yeah, well, coming as the wrestler, I believe that we're going to go to the ground at some point. And also, Paddy's kind of, you like being on your back.
Yeah.
A little too much, maybe, sometimes.
Yeah.
And I'm going to exploit that.
Yeah, no, what he means, you know what I mean? There, we're both like grappling backgrounds. I'm more jiu-jitsu, he's more wrestling. It is going to end up on the floor at some point, definitely. We're both comfortable on the floor, so it's going to end up on the floor at some point. I can't see myself on my back, though, to be fair, lad. I can't see myself on my back, and I know we're going to end up on the feet throwing down at some point. I know it's going to be an entertaining fight for the fans, and that's what I'm made up about more than anything, know what I mean? It's gonna be half a war. We're gonna stand in there, and we're gonna have a statement on the feet.
Yeah.
I know we are.
Both you guys are obviously outstanding on the mats, but I also think that both of you guys have got, really evolving stand-up games as well. Every fight begins on its feet, after all.
Yeah.
Søren, do you think you've got the edge in the stand-up?
I believe I'm as the more heavy opponent. I think I'll hit harder, but Paddy's definitely got some. Also weird moves, like his grappling, he's got some weird moves in his stand-up game, and that's hard to train for.
You've said in the build-up to this fight previously that you're predicting a TKO finish, second or third round.
Yeah.
That's a brave statement against someone that's never been finished.
Well, he might just give me the submission when he starts bleeding from every place in his face. It's see my fights. It's always happens like that.
I'm not Jacobson, no lad. I'm not Jacobson.
No, it's quite clear. I know that.
If I'm pouring with blood, I won't just give you the sub. I can't, lad. It's just bred into me not to. But like I said, you know what I mean? He's the heavier man. I know he's got knockout power. I've watched his fights. He's knocked people out before. You know what I mean? So obviously he thinks he's better than me everywhere, and I think I'm better than him everywhere. That's just the way it is. And that's why we're fighting. We're going to find out on September 1st who actually is.
What are Søren's biggest strengths then, Pat?
His wrestling. I think personally his wrestling and his knockout power. Because it doesn't matter who you are, anyone can get knocked out. anyone. We've seen it in boxing, we've seen it in MMA, any sport. Someone, you can be winning a fight for 4.5 rounds and then someone clips you on your chin and that's it, fight over. So that's obviously one thing that you've always got to look out for, and then obviously the wrestling, he's high caliber wrestler, so I've got to keep an eye out for that also.
Paddy, I thought scousers don't get knocked out.
They don't, lad.
Okay.
It's one of them, lad. So anyone can knock anyone out with one single shot. That is the way it is. You've got to look at it like that anyway. Yeah. Like, but I don't get knocked out.
That's
the thing. I don't get knocked out, but
all right.
Do get knocked out. I don't, though.
As you said, we'll find out.
So, exactly, yeah. We'll find out. That's it.
Sorry, you've described Paddy's style as loose, as unpredictable.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you prepare for somebody like Paddy Pimblett?
Well, I do a lot of stuff with high-level jiu-jitsu guys who likes that kind of style. So as much as it still will be unpredictable and hard to train for, it's kind of the best thing you can do to find the best grapplers and make them imitate the style.
Can anybody imitate your style?
No. I don't think they can, personally. Like, I don't think anyone can imitate my style, but I know what he means. People who are going to be going for submissions and stuff, being loose on the bottom and even on top as well, but no one can replicate my style. Let you know that now. No one can replicate my style. I am a weirdo. That's just the way it is. People in the gym say it to me, I'm a weirdo, and I actually am. I'm proper strange. I'm a weird kid.
The atmosphere in here, of course, every time Paddy headlines at the Echo Arena, something a little bit special happens.
Yeah.
You've tasted it. You've fought on the undercard before. What are you expecting from this crowd in Liverpool?
I'm kind of expecting them to be quite loud. And also a bit negativity towards me. I kind of put myself out there.
I was about to say, lad, all the LFC fans will be on your back. Yeah. Hey, lad, I've haven't got a problem with you, lad. I think you're sounding that, but for the Real Madrid top jib, I am one to have to hate you. Hey, I just thought I'd let you know now, I'm going to have to put it on you, lad.
Yeah. You're welcome to try. And they're welcome. Yeah, no, last time you lost here, they were kind of throwing beer. As long as it's beer, it's fine.
As long as it's beer, lad, it's sound, innit? Yeah. Pick it up and have a swig.
Yeah, exactly.
Flying.
The Real Madrid share prank was, you obviously went out and bought that specifically. It's not like you're a big Real Madrid fan.
That's true.
So wait a minute. So that doesn't mean
you wasted money on a Real Madrid top for one. You wasted your hard-earned money. I'm disappointed.
Well, they won, didn't they?
Come September the 1st, Soren, you're not going to do anything like walk out in a Man United shirt, are you?
Well, now I've kind of heard something about Paddy's. What do you think about Man United? I don't know. I won't predict anything about that.
Wouldn't that just rattle your cage even more, Pat?
Probably would. I hate Man United, like, but just don't even talk about United. You're going to be like Karius when you leave here. That's all I'm saying. You're going to be like Karius.
That's a statement.
This fight is obviously all the gold's on the line. It's a magnificent opportunity for Paddy to become a two-weight world champion under the Cage Warriors banner. For yourself, obviously, Cage Warriors champion of the world. But previous Paddy's opponents, you know, Nad, for instance, beat Paddy, got into the UFC.
Yeah.
People are obviously going to make that assumption. I'm sure you have as well. For you right now, hand on heart, what means more, winning the Cage Warriors belt or beating Paddy Pimblett?
It's beating Paddy Pimblett, because, as you say, it's kind of the gatekeeper to the UFC right now in Cage Warriors, at least in the lightweight division. So that's my ultimate goal, to become a UFC champion. This is a stepping stone for me.
You feel like a stepping stone?
No one feels like a stepping stone, do they? I know what you mean, obviously. Like, after Nad beat me, he got signed and stuff like that, and it's being spoke about with other people, but that's just the way it is, isn't it? Like, I don't like to say, I don't want to be big-headed, but I'm the biggest name in UK MMA, if not European MMA. So people are always going to think that, aren't they? If you get past Paddy, you'll get an UFC, or you get a title shot, know what I mean? But that's just the way it is. I don't mind. I'm leaving here with that belt on September 1st, so I can't see someone else getting signed to the UFC before I do.
You seem to be the only fighter in Europe that is not pursuing that UFC octagon. You're choosing your own path. You know, I think it's widely been publicised that UFC asked you to compete at UFC Liverpool, and you turned it down. The one thing that most European fighters wouldn't dream of doing. Mm. What was your logic behind that, Pat?
Like, Cage Warriors has done a lot for me, for one, you know what I mean? Cage Warriors has done a lot of fighting on there since I was 3-0, you know what I mean? I had like two fights on FCC while Cage Warriors had a little hiatus, but Cage Warriors has done a lot for me, and it was up to me. It was either you can sign for the UFC and fight on the UFC Liverpool card, or have a show in the Echo Arena in September. And it was like, if you don't say you're fighting on Cage Warriors, then they're not going to do that show. And like, it's not just about me. It's about, we've got amateurs in our gym who's saying their ass off to fight on stuff like this, and without Cage Warriors coming to the Echo Arena, they'd never have the chance to fight something like this at such a young age, you know what I mean? We've got 17-year-olds, 16-year-olds in the gym fighting in front of 6,000-8,000 people. They're ready to fight in front of anyone then, you know what I mean? If I turned that down and said, yeah, I'll fight on the UFC, never mind the fact that I was going to Mexico and I would have had to move my holiday, and that would have cost me money. This wouldn't have happened. This show wouldn't be happening on September 1st. They wouldn't be coming here. So my next gen family, my family comes first before anything else. You know what I mean? The UFC can come when it comes. I don't mind. I'm just, like you said, I'm 23. I'm a veteran in this sport, and I'm only 23. Been doing it since I was 15. I've seen the stewardess promoters and stuff like that come and go. I've been bumped by some promoters in the past, and I know what you're getting with Cage Warriors. You're getting a professionally run show, and that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna keep fighting on here, and then when the UFC come in with that big money offer, that's when I'll go. I'm getting nice wages for now at Cage Warriors, so when the UFC come in with a better offer, then I'll go. And I know soon enough they're gonna come in with a better offer, because the UFC needs Paddy Pimblett more than Paddy Pimblett needs the UFC. That's the way it is.
But it's not coming next, son.
No, it's not gonna be next time. But I know you have a few years on me. I'm turning 26 on Sunday, so I've been where you are. At least that way, where you kind of feel everything is ahead, and I'm a few years ahead, and it's kind of my time now.
Yeah, you know? I understand exactly where you're coming from, lad. Yeah. I understand where you're coming from. A few years older than me, and feel like it's your time. Yeah. Probably more mature and stuff like that, but I've lost here before, lad. Yeah. I've lost here before. I can't lose here again, lad. It was the worst night of my life. It was disgusting. It felt horrible. And I know it'll be the best night of your life if you come here and beat me here, lad, but that can't happen again, lad. I can't lose in here in front of my own fans. If you come here, lad, and beat me up here, you deserve that lightweight title. You do.
Well, thank you. And I'll just take a moment to credit you for being so mature that you turned down UFC because of all you can do for your gym. That's really amazing.
That's it, lad. Like, people don't see it, lad. Other gym, some gyms are just gyms, you know what I mean? Your gym might be the same as ours, lad. Our gym's like a family, you know what I mean? Like, everyone in there feel like they're my little brother, my little sister. Paul Rimmer really is like me second dad, you know what I mean? So I can't put myself first before all of them, you know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't be where I am today if it wasn't for all them being in the gym when I'm training for fights and helping me. So I can't forget about them and leave them behind. I'd rather us all do something together, and it just makes everything better, you know what I mean? If you all do it together and you all put it in, all the combined effort. Like last time when we fought here and I won the belt and Fishy won the belt, and I think one person lost from the gym that night, and like seven pros won and like four amateurs won, you know what I mean? And that really was one of the best nights of my life, and here winning that belt with all me family, me mates, me gym family, everything. It was just unbelievable. And like I'm saying, I'm hoping to replicate that again on September 1st, and in my head, lad, I am replicating that. It is happening. Obviously in your head it's the other way around, but
sorry
that's
to
just
ruin
it. That's it. That's just the way it is, lad. Yeah. That's happening.
You've obviously both visualised the finish. What happens in your mind, Søren?
Paddy ends up on the bottom. He's kind of loose and trying his armbars yet, and he's going to get elbows in the face, and he's going to be covered in blood, and then he's going to give me the submission.
Same question, Pat. How does it play out in your mind?
I'm going to land the long right hand, and Søren's going to be
sleep.
Yeah, that's like I've dreamed it. You know what I mean? I've dreamed it. Like what happened with Frazee. No one thought I was gonna knock him out. Everyone thought it'd be a grapple, but I can see us both grappling, shutting each other down, and we just end up standing up and throwing bombs at each other. I can see me putting him faster kick.
I know, Søren, you've said previously that you're going to be too big, too strong. Looking at you both today, though, it looks like Paddy's probably a little bit taller. Are you surprised how big he is?
No, because I'm actually quite a small height-wise in the lightweight division. I'm quite thick, and everything is there for a reason. So people usually are surprised when they try to move me, try to take me down, but just the sheer strength in my body, yeah.
That's something you often get asked about as well, that people think you've got, because of your boyish good looks, Pad, they think you've got a boyish strength as well, but you've also got that inner strength. You're able to take fights where you want them to go.
Well, it is me and Antoine are like different body types. I'm like tall and not as wide, where he's the other way, opposite it. Like me and Fishy, two different body types, you know what I mean? And it makes you have better things for you against that opponent when you go into the fight. That's all it is. It's just for game planning and stuff like that when you go in there. It's your body type just helps certain things what you're good at. You know what I mean? It's not going to make a difference, really, when you come out there. Who's wider, who's this? It comes down to who's more technical, who wants it more, who's put the hard work in.
And we both will be prepared for the difference of body types. So
when it comes down to it on the night, the body types aren't going to make a difference because we're both going to be prepared for it.
Technically, then, who is the better fighter? Striker, you know, the full package?
We're both going to say the other person, aren't we? Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, we're both going to say the other person. I think I've got the better body type for striking. So if you want to try and keep it long, you know what I mean? Soren's got the better body type of wrestling. And then when it comes to jiu-jitsu, it doesn't matter about body type. I don't think it's just if you're good at it. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter what type of body you've got. People with shorter limbs can be better at some stuff than people with longer limbs. That's just the way it is. But I think I'm better striking. I even think I've got better wrestling, to be fair, and jiu-jitsu. You know what I mean? Like, that's the way it is. I can't go into a fight thinking I'm not confident, because I am. No matter, put Conor McGregor in front of me, put Anderson Silva in front of me, I'll still think I'm going to put it on you, on the feet, on the ground, or wrestling.
Is it the submission game then you're scared of getting involved in, Søren? Is that a red light for you?
Well, no. Actually not, because I think we're both very technical in all the aspects. It's just a matter of kind of the thought process and how we take it strategically goes about it, where I believe that I go for more high percentage moves and I'm much more tight and don't advance if I see a big risk involved. So I'm maybe taking it a bit more slowly than a flying armbar, but but when I get a hold of you, I'm gonna keep that hold until I get what I want.
Yeah, he's spot on there, but we're both very technical fighters. You know what I mean? We don't come out and swing loosely and go for stuff. Everything we go for, it's tactical. You know what I mean? We know why we're doing it. We won't just come in and go, oh, I'm gonna throw this and then get caught in something. You know what I mean? It won't work like that. It's gonna be a very strategic, technical fight.
So okay then. So you've both paid each other tons of compliments here. From what I can see, then, it comes down to one thing. Who wants it most? So what does a win here do for you in your life and your career?
That's kind of what I've been working for my whole career. This point where I can get this championship and I can move on to the next division. I can move on to UFC. That's the end goal for me, and it has been my whole career. So this is the combination of my whole career and just stepping up to the next level.
Well, for me, I'll be honest, I'll probably win this belt and then have another fight on Cage Warriors. Cage Warriors 100's only round the corner, so I'm game to fight on that, know what I mean? I'll try and get back down to featherweight and beat someone up.
Going back to featherweight.
Beat someone
possible?
Up for that belt, or I don't know if it's possible. I'll go up to welterweight and get that belt, know what I mean? If someone's fighting for that on the weekend, I'll go up to welterweight and fight for that belt at Cage Warriors 100. But like I said, I can't come here again and lose. Like I said, that when I lost to Nadan Amani, that was one of the worst nights of my life. The only things I can compare to that is my nan dying and my grandma dying. You know what I mean? Like, they are the only things that I can compare to losing that fight. So I can't lose in here. You know what I mean? I can't lose in here. Whether it's for the belt, whether it weighing for the belt, whether it was fighting on the undercard, I can't lose in here again. It's just not happening.
Two of the best young talents in all of Europe. Cage Warriors 96 for the vacant lightweight championship of the world. Don't miss it.